In order to do overhead variances, here's what we're going to do. As I said, all the variances are done in the flexible budget equation. What was the flexible budget equation we've learned in the past? We learned total cost equals fixed plus variable times X. That's your flexible budget equation. Fixed plus variable times X. Total costs are fixed plus variable times X. You've got your fixed overhead plus your variable overhead per hour times X is your activity level. So X is some cost driver, some activity level. So our flexible budget equation is total cost equals fixed plus variable times X. When you're doing flexible budget, when you do the budget, within a budget, what costs are normally the same, fixed or fixed? Remember, within the relevant range, fixed or fixed, variable or fixed per unit, we're looking at the X, which is the cost driver, the activity level. So that's called our flexible budget equation. We're trying to figure out what total costs will be at different levels of activity, X being your cost driver. So if we're doing all of our overhead analysis using, so we're going to always compare something with the flexible budget equation. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to look at, on the left side, we're going to start here with our actual overhead. Actual overhead. We're going to compare that with our flexible budget equation at actual. We're going to compare that with our flexible budget equation at standard. And then we're going to compare that with standard at standard. What is standard at standard? That's called applied. That's your applied overhead. That's the overhead you applied into what? WIP. WIP it good. Remember that WIP, work in process? That's the amount we applied into work in process. So with overhead, again, don't lose sight of the big picture. What is overhead? All the other costs in the factory except which? Direct materials, direct labor. We already did materials and labor. Now we're looking at overhead. So in the factory, what do we have? We have fixed costs like rent. We have variable costs like electricity, glue, screws, nuts, bolts. So what we're looking at are the fixed and the variable. We're trying to look at how we did in the factory. How we did in the factory. Did we spend too much for fixed or variable? Did we waste hours of electricity efficiency in the factory? Was our production capacity up or down? Volume. So that's what we're looking at. Now notice, here's actual. I'm always going to start with actual because it's given. Then we're going to compare that with our flexible budget at actual, our flexible budget at standard, and applied is basically standard at standard. That's what you applied into work in process. Now, when I have 1, 2, 3, 4, when you have four numbers, I'm looking at the differences. 1, 2, 3. Four numbers gives you how many differences? 1, 2, 3. Four numbers gives you three differences. What is 4 plus 3, everybody? 7, spending efficiency volume, spending efficiency volume. This is called your spending variance, the difference between actual and your flexible budget at actual. That's how much you spend. This is called your efficiency variance. How efficient were you? That's the difference between your budget at actual and your budget at what got applied. And the last one is called your volume variance. That is your production volume, the difference between your flexible budget at standard and what got applied into WIP. Because you were over or under applied, over or under applied. So what we're looking at is the difference between spending, efficiency, volume. 4 plus 3 is what?
7.
Thank you, 7, spending, efficiency, volume. So that's a quick overview of where we're going to go. Now, this is actual, so this is fixed plus variable times X. So for both of these formulas, fixed is the same. Variable is the same. It's the X that changes. X is either actual at actual, or X is standard allowed for actual. The key is study hard. Don't get discouraged. Ooh, do a little Michael Jackson walk. Come on down. I've been teaching almost 20 years after I left Deloitte and Touche. I've done this for many, many years, helped thousands and thousands of people accomplish their goal, which is to get through the exam.